Hi there, once again on Lab. Today we're gonna be migrating to Kubernetes. Right here, I'm installing Apache tools. That would be Apache Bench. Yes. At the shell, I'm doing it. Okay, let's check if that worked. Perfect. Apache Bench dash version. Now we're going to clone a repo. I go to cd migrations to DKE. That's everything you had. Perfect. Let's set up region, set up zone, okay. Okay, from the menu, okay, let me open the editor. I'm gonna use the Terraform. Open variables df. I want to set off micro F1 micro standard one, save it. To do something here. Our memo's on the root. We're launching everything to create all the stuff we had predefined Terraform. File. Creating the Docker images. Create a storage. Compute engine, furrow, so the storage run very fast. Furrow has been doing container clusters prime cluster. All the things created directly from the script. Here we go, there is a cluster to be created. That really takes a while. provide all the code we have here inside Terraform, all the other scripts. It's long files. You can create a class takes really more than 5 minutes. There's our make file. There's also a Jenkins file. Have two number of notes. Well, using the Terraform, you could create cluster to all the other infrastructure. Infrastructure as a code. Gonna be providing all the things from here, all the code. You can use that to create your own stuff as an example. Let's just create it. Prime server. From server is workload, let's see the service. There's a node port itself there, you can check the port or the external port. That gonna be available in fill. Another IP address. The script that will be launching with using more than 20 minutes. Gonna be a long video. It's a Flask application, Python stuff. Here you go, success, start a successful startup. Good. Let's get the web server. It's getting to dead. Phrase. Now we are in that. Let's see, like BS that all UX. Have everything inside that, checking what's running on. Then we can exit this machine. Good. I can do this. Phrase. Great. I get inside here. I'm going to clone an application inside that. Let's go in deep there. Let's build a Docker image inside that. Perfect. Whoa, I just got these, my command to get all the list of processing running on this port. So you got we're gonna kill -967-63. No process over there. We could kill the first crownless one, like, oh sorry, I was looking to another number, look at first of it. You see they're only one right now. What can we do? Run image. All the process is running. You can see the chronos. Was correct. Let's run another interesting command. Wow, unicorn. Perfect. Can exit. Let's get into the cluster. let's execute that inside the first prime server. It's running over that. Let's do a make validate. Factor of them. Of 10 is all right. So let's do a little testing. Open another tab. Can be there. ID's address. Apache Bench. Can try accessing this. Give you the timestamp. Son of all primes. Let's leave all the benchmarks. Gonna fail, that's my intention. I'm going to do one thing, I'm going to scale. Let's be back here. Longest requests. Okay, that's one. Back again here. Let's run that again. I have three pods. You got the results before. Time taken for the test, remember this number. Now I have three pods. Just a way to understand a little bit how that works, you get into the pods, you see they're using the kubectl exec, installed something on the node, use the compute engine node from here, directly using the shell. Close it. It was last time. Very small. Time taking for the tests. Complete requests. Look. 12,000. 7,000. Let's scale more. Get in here. Can get from here. Wow, look how fast that goes. We do kubectl get pods. Container crawl, we're running it, but you're at zero, it's a 101. Back again. All that are running should be green. Let's run the same and check. From 7,000 to 12,000 requests. That thing though, then we gotta break down the that's the timing for all of them, 1 minute. You see the difference. $15,000. So you see the difference of the scalability using the pods for our larger requests, longest requests, much less. Thanks for watching. See you in the next video. Hope you enjoyed this migrating to Kubernetes. Bye bye.